morning from 2, top of the morning. That's just going by here early morning, getting to it. On my way down to the ports, doing my local trucking thing. Now this morning, I just want to holler at y'all a little bit about, you know, driving local. Local work for me is, I love it, you know what I'm saying? This is the thing, everybody has their own thing, you know? Everybody either want an OTR or you want to go local, regional, you know, there's all different ways in this business. But I'm local now, you know? When I started, I was OTR, of course. That's how I got my feet wet. I got my experience up. Now I'm running local, owner operated. And you know, I can't complain. You know, I'm running the ports, all the containers local. I don't travel far, man. You know, I got a little cold, but yeah, I run local, man. All the containers. It's easy. Of course, you got your good, you got your bad when it comes to the local work. You know, I don't run far. Mile-wise, I don't probably drive no more than 100 miles a day. And I'm still making good money at the end of the day. You know what I'm saying? The average guy doing local, at minimum, 400 a day. Okay? That's like a minimum. If you out here, at this time, you can make that within the first 8 hours of your drive time. You know, you got the e-logs. Even though we're local, we still run the e-logs. But you got ample amount of time to do what you need to do. So, is there money in local? Of course there's money in. But like to everybody, levels to it. You know, you might be that company guy starting out at 19, 21 an hour running the ports, and that's around like the pay I see out here for local, port driving, for local work. They starting around 19 to $20 an hour, which in hindsight is better than working at, you know, anywhere else. This industry, there's money in the industry, period, at the end of the day. So, it's not a bad wage if that's how you want to do it. If you know, because the way out here when you're moving in your own truck, you got to pay for everything, right? I pay for fuel, insurance, I pay for breakdowns, tires. Like, just the other day, I just bought that whole set of drives. I got 8 new tires on the back. Since I'm local, I bought 8 brand new recaps, but they're hella nice. On missions, you know, they feeling good. They running good. When I'm under a load, the ride smooth. You know, that alone hit me for almost $1,100. You know, paying for the tires and then paying for me to get mounted. So that's out of my pocket. You know, it comes from the game. You gotta pay to play. You gotta pay to play. But, you know, you gotta keep the truck up. DOT is out here. They out here. CHP, they out here. Doing random stops, you know, when you're coming out the terminals, you know, so you gotta be ready. Every day they out here, so you gotta do your best to maintain your truck. You know, me personally, I keep up with my truck, make make sure it's well lubricated, make sure oil change, you know, the basic maintenance. When things happen, of course, things are going to happen. You got to just solve the problem, get it fixed, get back on the road. Saying that local, you're either going to be a company driver or you're going to be a owner. Now, I was a driver once upon a time when I first started in the courts because I didn't know. When I said a driver, meaning I didn't own the truck. I was still getting paid on a 1099, but it wasn't my truck. I was driving for another guy. And I did that solely because I wasn't familiar with the court, so I didn't want to put myself in a position where I was paying for a truck, and then I don't really understand the system down here. But now, I know it like the back of my hand. So that's why I had upgraded, got into purchasing a truck. And how did I get the truck? Yes, I did do a lease purchase deal, but the deal was so good I couldn't refuse. So I basically picked up this truck by picking up a loan. Another driver had this truck, but he couldn't afford the payment, so I basically picked up the back end of the loan, which was not much at all, and paid it off within a year and a half. So am I proud of myself? Of course I am, you know. I came in, I mean, like I said, I started OTR, came local. I still was a company driver, basically, as a driver. I got my, learned what I needed to learn. And now, you know, not to my own horn, but I feel like I'm a successful young trucker, owner-oppin' at the local level. Some may say local, you know, oh, you don't work hard, y'all ain't making no money. I just can't, you know, everybody got a different situation at the end of the day. You know, everybody got their own preference, everybody got their own situation. The money is going to be different across the board. It's, you know, to me, when it comes to working local, it's all about you. How hard are you willing to push each and every day? Are you willing to wake up 5:30 in the morning, you know, shower, shave, get to the yard, start that truck up, get out here and start running by 6:30, you know, picking up your first container by 7:30 and busting until at least, I say, working minimum at least 10 hours a day. You're going to do just fine out here. And some may think I'm bullshitting, or some may say, oh, that's not true, but that's the reality, bro. And yeah, you get to go home to your family. What's wrong with that? You know what I'm saying? I love the fact that I get to go see my wife, see my daughter at the end of my shifts when I'm done working. And am I under anybody's rule where I'm on a schedule? No, I'm not. I move how I want to move. That's why I do enjoy it. I'm not bogged down by time, schedule, boss, none of that. I'm not tied down. So that's just my perspective on local. Local can be good for some. Local may be bad for some. OTR good for some. OTR not good for some. Everybody's situation is different. And, you know, I feel like you got to take each man's situation as is. If that working for that man, you know, more power to you. Do what you do, you know what I'm saying? Do your thing out here. But to any of you new rookie truckers, you know, OTR is probably going to be your first gig because out here in Cali, you got to, for a fact, have a minimum of 1 year experience. All these cars out here, it's a lot of traffic. You know, you're dealing with traffic, you're dealing with city streets, you're dealing with tight areas, so you gotta have some type of experience. not going to insure you, so these companies will not hire you. It's all, you know, it's all about the insurance company at the end of the day when it comes to experience in trucking. Even older out, the more experience you have, the less your insurance will cost you. And once you establish with an insurance company, over time, your rates will drop. As if, like, you had regular car insurance. Same deal. So there's levels to all of this, though, bro. But I guess I just wanted to talk a little bit about local work, period. And if it's a good catch, for me, it's good. It works for me. You know, I'm talking about myself. This works for me. And it obviously works for a lot of others down here. States, the poor work may not be the same because they're not as large as us. You know, this place is massive. Just right now, like, I'm getting down in the area of where, I'm basically on the Long Beach side right now of the ports, getting off. So I'm basically showing you right now. As you see in the back, there's like refineries and shit, all kind of, there's just stuff everywhere around here, refineries, ports, it's everything, man. You know, Long Beach is a blue-collar city, man. A lot of people may not know that, but it is. It's a lot of refinery work, a lot of truck drivers, mechanics, you know, just hard-working people. Of course, you got your corporate guys, but that's not who we are, you know. We work hard, we go hard, we take care of our families, and that's what we do each and every day. You know, some of us, most truckers, I'll be honest and say, probably do make more money than a person with a college degree. And that's the topic for another day. It don't take me long to get down here, maybe about 10 minutes from where I park my truck to get down here, and I'm pretty much in this area for the day, unless I decide to take a load further out, which I hardly do, but now that I got these new set of tires, I am willing to go out a little further. Of course, it pays more, but I find my to be averaging better when I just stay within this 15-mile radius dropping these loads off. It might sound crazy, but I'm literally in a 15-mile radius all day, during the day, unless I go further. Dropping my loads, picking up empties, doing things of that nature. 99% of what I do is dropping the hoodie. So, time-wise, the only time that you are getting consumed with, mostly when you're running local, is the traffic. If you're jumping on the freeway, like here, Cali, there's traffic all the damn time. And that's just part of the game. And the ports, it's all up to the longshoremen if you're going to have a good day. Like, basically, if they over there working good, everything flowing, or they just chilling. So it's all part of the game. You gotta go with the flow. As you can see, they're building this new bridge. Right now, I'm getting on the original one, but the one that you see that they were building in the background there, I don't think this one will be shut down completely. To my left, we just passed up one of the terminals that is completely automated, meaning when you go in, you have automated cranes, automated tellers, like all that. To me, that's one of the most efficient ports. Terminals here, the Long Beach port, the Long Beach terminal. Because your turn time in there, I say no more than 15, 20 minutes, you're in and you're out. Because you're not dealing with the politics, you know what I mean? You're dealing with machines. You're coming over the bridge right here. can see, like, if you look to your left, all that over there, that's Cottage Hill. That's actually where I'm headed right now. This is one of the larger terminals. You know, they are big at the end of the day. You know, there's thousands and thousands of containers in each of these terminals. I just want to give you guys a little insight on what's going on when it comes to me and what I do for my living work. So, hope y'all enjoyed the video. If y'all did, like and subscribe. Share it with your friends, your partners, anybody you know trying to get in the trucking. I will be bringing more videos, you know, some more in-depth videos about certain things when it comes to trucking. I'm going to start working on those type of videos to bring more of an informational situation to help guide you rookies or those who are, you know, confused on what they want to do. They want to get a trucking or not. Like, we want to start bringing that kind of content for you guys. So just stay tuned, like and subscribe, and I appreciate y'all. Keep your eyes and ears open, watching everything move, and I'll holler at y'all later.